Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I thought it would be fun to show you how to recreate the movie poster of The Martian using your own face or anyone else's. I provided a Photoshop template that includes the poster's astronaut spacesuit and a channel that we'll use to place a face inside the helmet. I also provided an image of a Martian landscape that we'll use as a reflection over the face on the glass of the helmet. They're both located in my video's description or project files below. In addition, I included a link for the font that was used in the poster. Open a sharp, well-lit photo of a face looking directly at you. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. If your photo needs its brightness and/or contrast adjusted, open the Levels window by pressing Ctrl or Command L. Since every photo is different, their input shadows, midtones, and highlights need to be adjusted differently. For this photo, I'd like to darken its midtones, so I'll drag the input midtone slider to the right. We'll convert our subject into a smart object so we can continue to modify it non-destructively and, if we want to, replace it with a different face without having to redo the effects. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. To place it into the poster, make sure your Move tool is active. If it isn't, press V on your keyboard. Drag it onto the tab of the poster, and without releasing your mouse or pen, press and hold Shift as you drag it down and release. Pressing Shift kept it centered over the document. Don't size it just yet. Open your Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Control-click or Command-click the black and white channel to make a selection of its shape. Open back the Layers panel and click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the active layer. To resize the face inside the layer mask, click the Chain Link icon to unlink the layer and the layer mask. Doing this allows us to resize and/or reposition either of them independently of the other. Make the face active and press Ctrl or Command T to open your Transform tool. If the Transform's bounding box is outside your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. To reposition it, go inside the bounding box and drag it. Size and position it so you don't see the ears, and the bottom of the chin should rest at the bottom of the layer mask. If the face is slightly at an angle, you'll want to straighten it by going outside the bounding box near a corner, and when you see a curved double arrow, rotate it until the face is vertical. Then press Enter or Return. To fit it back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Reduce the opacity of the face to 80%. Open the Martian landscape I provided. We'll give it a convex distortion to conform to the curved glass of the helmet. But first, we'll convert it into a smart object so we can do it non-destructively. Go to Filter and Lens Correction. Click the Custom tab and drag the geometric distortion to the left approximately this much. Convert it into a smart object once again and drag it onto the tab of the poster. As before, without releasing your mouse or pen, press and hold Shift as you drag it down and release. Go to the layer mask and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of it next to the Mars landscape. Change the blend mode to overlay. will reduce the size of the Martian landscape over the helmet. Open your Transform tool and see its entire bounding box. Reduce the landscape over the helmet and fit it onto your canvas. Continue to adjust its size and position. Then press Enter or Return. Reduce its opacity to approximately 50%. Next, we'll darken the top of the forehead since the helmet is casting a shadow over it. Make the face layer active and click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Control-click or Command-click the layer mask to make a selection of its shape. We'll expand the selection to ensure that the entire area of the forehead will be darkened. Go to Select, Modify, and Expand. Expand it by 6 pixels. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the empty layer. Make the empty layer active and open your Gradient tool. Make sure the Linear Gradient icon is active. Open your Gradient thumbnails, and if you don't see the black to transparent thumbnail, click the gear icon and click Reset Gradients. Then, click the black to transparent thumbnail. Go to the top of the forehead and press and hold Shift as you drag down the Gradient tool halfway down and release. Change the Blend Mode to Overlay. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J and reduce its opacity to 50%. Next, we'll add a highlight spot which gives the appearance of a sun flare on the helmet's glass. Make the top layer active and click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Change its Blend Mode to Overlay and name it Highlight. Open your Brush tool and Brush Picker. Make its size 250 pixels and the hardness 0%. The opacity and flow are both 100%. Place your cursor halfway over an edge of the face and click once. Feel free to reposition the flare by pressing V to open your Move tool and dragging it. Next, we'll add the text. Open your Horizontal Type tool, and if you want to use the same font as in the real poster, open UVF Bourgeois Medium, for which I provided the link to. Make its size 68 points, sharp, center alignment, and white for the color. Click the Character Paragraph Panels icon. If you don't see it, go to Window and Character. Make its leading 106 points. Leading increases or decreases the amount of space between lines of text. Make its tracking 140. Tracking is the amount of space between letters in a word, line, or paragraph. The horizontal and vertical scales are 100%. Click on your document and type out your text. To center it on your poster, click the Move tool and press Ctrl or Command A to select your canvas. Click the Align Horizontal Centers icon and the Align Vertical Centers icon. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.